body and get here early, because as school starts back up, a bunch of our regulars are going to come back. I love having a super full room, but I want us to have time to get set up, not feel rushed, all the things. So for many people, school started today, and for the rest of us, school starts a week from today. So ready or not, here it comes. So today I want us to focus on Genesis 1:27. Whenever it states how Jesus created human beings, he created man and woman in his image. And I recently got to hear Tim Tebow speak, and he shared about whenever we look at the original Hebrew translation of in his image, other cultures and other old historical writings have used that same phrase. But that same phrase was used to describe Pharaoh, who they viewed as a god, used to describe an ancient king who those people worshipped as their godlike creatures. And so it's so sweet, while it's a verse that we have read and heard over and over again, but the original translation is, it says, we are all royalty. Every person that walks this earth, man and woman, is described as royalty. And I know for me, I've taken for granted the word or the thought that I am the daughter of a king. But that is how we are even described from the very first book of the Bible. And so I want us to move our bodies and breathe in that truth, but even further, what that looks like moving through within our day-to-day. And do we view those around us as royalty, as daughters, as sons of a king? I recently got back from vacation, and last week we got to do the whole, my husband and I, the whole all-inclusive Caribbean resort where you just are able to escape all the things. But looking back, it didn't take long. Y'all know a lot of the journey that brought us to Holy Bar centers around different struggles with body image and what the world tells us we should look like and workout and fitness and all that kind of stuff. And while the Lord has provided so much freedom for me personally, and I pray for so many others, I step into this all-inclusive resort where everyone's in this itty-bitty bathing suit, and it didn't take me long to start comparing, critiquing, and so much came to the surface, where then I'm realizing, like, oh my goodness, worldly beauty and how you're supposed to look is such a moving target, because now we get into all the cosmetic procedures. And like, you're just looking around, and it's just, I realize that my body can be a source of pride, and then you start feeling insecure about certain things. And like, just within this first day, my mind just becomes a mess. And I could just see the enemy just like digging into all this stuff. So thankfully, I've learned the tools to take a step back. I mean, guys, there were butt implants everywhere. And it's just one that so then it just starts breaking my heart, not only convicting me of my own sin and struggles and believing the lies, but then you just see everyone chasing this false idol of whatever we think we should look like. And then whenever it's an unlimited alcohol environment, the vulnerability and what people start sharing with you because they feel like you're a safe person that they'll never see again. Whew. Like, I would just lay in bed at night and be like, oh my gosh, there's so much brokenness in this world because people were honest. And so processing all of that, but then I am so grateful that this week I got reminded that even before we were created, we were fearfully and wonderfully made in his image, period. All that stuff, our value is not in any of that. And we are called to love and view everyone else in that royalty and step into their vulnerability. The other thing is, this week, my daughter's starting soccer. And youth sports, bless, but competitive soccer, she's 8. And she is spending this week and next week getting ranked among all her peers. And I'm thankful that the Lord gave her a natural ability where she's able to drive. But like, I'm already having the conversations with her about, she made a team, but some of her best friends didn't. And it's just for this weekend. It doesn't even count. Blah, 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 blah. And it makes me go back to, yeah, I can take her out of it, but I can't take her out of the world. And so I'm trying to start the conversations with her. And one of my favorite studies of all times is Matt Chandler's A Beautiful Design. And it talks about Genesis 1:27, where we are created in the image of God. And he talks about the hurdles of women and says that so many of our hurdles are comparison and perfectionism. And I always go back to that. Because guys, I don't care how old we are. I don't care what we've gone through. And there's so much hurt and real things. But the enemy is going to try to fill our minds with comparison and perfectionism. And so I want us to just move our bodies, knowing that the Lord delights in us. We are fearfully, wonderfully made. We are beautiful because we are full of his beauty, period. And whether we make a soccer team or we don't, whether we look good in a bikini or we don't, whether our marriage is thriving or our marriage is really in the pits right now, we are fearfully and wonderfully made and we are created in his image, period. Amen. So let's go ahead and stand up and we will get started as we move our bodies in love. This is one of my favorite tanks because sometimes I want to preach it. Sometimes I need to be reminded of it, whatever it looks like. But we get to move our bodies. This is a time of worship because in John 4, Jesus says that we can worship in spirit and in truth in everything that we do. This is not a time to burn calories. This is not a time to give ourselves a sexy butt. This is time to move our bodies in love and breathe in his goodness, and let's have some fun with it. I want us to stand at the edge of our mat. Big inhale up, take it down. One more. Thank you for creating us with these good bodies. We ask that you clear our minds, calm our souls, fill our hearts, and strengthen our bodies. In your precious name, amen. We're going to stand up, sending those arms back. Really take deep breaths right here. As you send those arms back, press your chest forward. Press up through those heels. One more. Hold it down. Then we're going to slowly come up. Take your feet wide. You can straddle your mat. We're going to go side to side. Feet are parallel, facing each other. Really utilize those heels to send your body side to side. Keep that core engaged. I want your belly and your breath engaged this whole time. We're going to reach forward. Lower and down. into that right leg. We're going to extend it. You can extend your other arm forward. Just raise and lower. Pick a spot on the floor to stare. I'm impressed. None of y'all are touching the wall. Y'all are challenging it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. We're going to hold it up. Option. You can set that back use your core to support you. Make sure you aren't straining those shoulders. Four,
into child's pose.
Lift that leg high in the air.
This little light of mine.
You can sit crisscross applesauce, whatever's comfortable. Palms on your knees.
This little light of mine.
Roll your head around slowly. Maybe it's your heart for others.